It was once said, "You sound awfully bored when you read your poems." I guess they can't say that now, because I've seen the Americans and I have been with them across the pond, but, of course, never taken the boat. They sound how I want to sound when my shield is down, but my problem, like before the beginning of this poem, is the tears will flow, and that is why I can't get through this mode I'm in, because as soon as I'm asked, how do I feel about that, I either explode or cry a river by a proof rock. Red. Blue. And purple. At the wall, absent with fading marks and blue tack stains, sayings I will try to reclaim, although I am unsure who I was before. One, you are not alone. Don't give up just because it hurts. Two, you are better and stronger than you think. How can this be true? All you can think of is nothing, and nothing of pain. Three, you can make hope happen just by being you.
At least half the tributes want you as an ally.
Well, they saw her shoot.
Well, sweetheart, you got your pick of the litter.
I want Wyrus and Beatty.
Joanna calls them nuts and bolts.
Well, okay, good. Now, who else?
Mags. All right, fine, then no one.
Thank you. My stylist is such an idiot. District 7, lumber, trees. Oh, I'd love to put my axe in her face. So what do you think, now that the whole world wants to sleep with you?
I don't think that the whole world...
I wasn't talking to you.
Okay.
You want zip?
That you need, and I can read between the lines. Yeah, gather your friends and wave your gun in my face, but I will use my voice.
The broad podcast cut out here before any of the excitement happened.
How many people saw it?
Hard to say. There was a 5-second delay, but it happened fast.
Those are drawings of the Jabberjay. It was created as a weapon, an organic spy mutt. And when the program was shut down, an extermination order was issued, but carelessly executed. Some of them escaped, flew into the wild, mated with mockingbirds. So now we have the mockingjay. Species that shouldn't exist, an offspring from our neglect that is beyond our control. If you cannot contain Katniss Everdeen, then I will have to terminate her.
I understand that.
And not just her. Her entire species has to be eliminated.
Her species, sir?
The other vectors.
In the square.
Watching the pale body, so still and quiet, I lean forward and whisper, "What should I take with me? It might be a long trip." The eyes blink but do not speak. I am left staring at an empty suitcase. I look inside and smell the familiar rose scent of Nan. I smile. I was being overcautious. She never took a bag. She never had time. Not even the borrowed kind. But is she happy? Bored? Maybe. She liked to keep busy. The body trembles then. I rearrange the covers. It's always good to leave the room the way you wish to find it. Just in case. The eyes gesture to the bookshelf. I frown. How am I meant to pick? There are so many. The body remains still.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the 75th year of the Hunger Games. And it was written in the Charter of the Games that every 25 years there would be a quarter quell. To keep fresh for each new generation the memory of those who died and the uprising against the capital. Each quarter quell is distinguished by games of a special significance. And now, on this, the 75th anniversary of our defeat of the rebellion, we celebrate the third quarter quell. As a reminder that even the strongest cannot overcome the power of the capital. On this, the third quarter quell games, the male and female tributes are to be reaped from the existing pool of victors in each district.
The spine is bent, a squished up coil, strained black by shadow. Wake up, rise up to the distorted mirror, wipe the sand from your eyes.
What do you propose?
Shut down the black markets, take away what little they have, then double the amount of floggings and executions, put them on TV, broadcast them live. Sow fear, more fear.
It won't work. Fear does not work as long as they have hope. And Katniss Everdeen is giving them hope. Now, because of her, they all pose a threat. Because of her, they all think they're invincible. Whatever game you think you're playing, those out there are not playing it with you.
If these bars of steel become cold enough, they will be brittle like my bones. And dance in the shadows of cascading light. A new day will come in this reflection, an absent interplay. Wake up, rise up, the story isn't over yet. There can be a better, more powerful you, a better world.
The President Snow, as usual, was right.
Was he not, folks?
I love it! I love it! Don't you love it, folks? It's incredible! It's so gorgeous!
Will you do us the honor, please? Please, please.
Like a mockingjay.
Your stylist certainly has outdone himself this time,
hasn't he? What theatricality! Sit down! Take a bow!
If it weren't... If it weren't for the baby.
All right, this is news. Let's find out more. Calm down. This is news to all of us. All right. Let's, everybody calm down. It's a great night, great night. This is news to all of us. All right, all right, all right. We're going to find out what we do about this. What's
seems to be laid out like a clock, with a new threat every hour, but they stay only within their wedge. It all starts with the lightning, then the blood rain, fog, monkeys. That's the first 4 hours. At 10, that big wave hits from over there.
Iris, you're a genius.
But the tail points to 12.
That's where the lightning strikes at noon and midnight.
Strikes where?
That big tree.
Good.
Dickory Dock. The mouse ran up the clock. The clock struck one, the mouse ran down. Dickory, Dickory Dock. Dickory, Dickory Dock.
So 12 to 1, lightning. Then 1 to 2 is blood. Then fog. And then monkeys.
Hickory, Dickory Dock. The dog barked at the clock. The clock struck.
And then 10 to 11, the wave. What about everything else? Did you guys see anything?
Hickory, Dickory Dock.
Nothing but blood.
It doesn't matter. As long as you steer clear whichever sect is active, we'll be safe.
Yeah, relatively speaking.
Change it up. Spin it.
Friends I have for free. Everybody else I owe something to, or I'm now afraid of, or we don't seem to be talking the same language. Oh, and of course I can't see them. So, if birds of a feather do, in fact, stick together, then what am I seeing? Softness? A glimpse of another world, maybe. An injury. Or am I seeing the separated? Just like me.
I lay dying, and I'm pouring crimson regret, then betrayal. I'm dying, praying, bleeding, and screaming.
What are your injuries?
Bruised ribs, bruised lung.
I'm surprised they haven't found you a new lung. I mean, I've got two. Do you want one of mine? I mean, it's everybody's job to keep you alive.
Is that why you hate me?
Partly. You're also a little hard to swallow. The whole tacky romance drama and the defender of the hopeless act, even though it's not an act, which makes it even more unbearable. Feel free to take any of this personally.
You should have been a Mockingjay. Nobody has to tell you what to say.
But nobody likes me.